All right, joining us on Hot Coffee, and he was hot, hot, hot yesterday, is Senator Judge Franklin Drilon. Good day to you. Good morning, Senator. Thank you for coming.
Hi, Karen. Good morning.
All right. Okay, gusto ko maintindihan to ng mga non-lawyers who are watching. All right? I am holding with me, which I cannot show, zoom in on camera, as ruled by presiding officer Enrile, but we have a copy. On the master, these are the customer identification and specimen signature cards of PS Bank. In the same card, you will see dollar and peso accounts that were opened by Corona in the bank.
Account numbers.
Ano po ba talaga ang hinihingi ng mga senator judges? Gayong sinabi na ng PS Bank, fake daw ang document na ito.
All right. Kagaya po ni Jingoy Estrada, ako po hindi naniniwala na fake ito. Dahilan sa kung titingnan natin, itong signature card, lahat naman tayo dumaan dyan na pumirma ng signature card. It would appear to be authentic on its face. Okay. Ngayon, kaya po aking dahil sila po ang nagsabi na ito'y peke, kailangan naman, may karapatan kami mga senator judges to probe and ask and test the credibility of the witness because she made or they made a conclusion, an opinion that this is fake. And therefore, we have the right to ask, as Senator really has sustained us, the right to see whether it is fake. So what did I ask yesterday? First, I'm not talking about the dollar account, just the peso account. Mayroon po nakalagay dyan na mga peso account numbers.
Oo, nandito po
nandito.
Yun. May mga column po dito.
Ngayon, mayroon dyan authorized officer who opened the account.
Mga signature.
Eh, hindi mo naman pwede sabihin na fake yan. Sino ito? Sino itong pumirmang ito? For the peso accounts. So para natin malaman kung talagang hindi niya pinirmahan to o kanginong pirma ito. Mm-mm. Ngayon, may mga dollar account dyan. Ako, I'm just reserving my judgment.
Actually, dalawa.
Dalawa. Pero ito, numero lang. Walang
numero
amount.
Lang.
Ngayon, itong mga numero ito, ay sinabi din ni Garcia na existing. But never mind.
Wag na yon.
Wag na yon. Best to. But ang sinasabi nila kahapon, there were yung mga highlighting daw, wala doon sa kanilang kopya. Hinighlight daw ang ganito, wala doon sa kanila. Kung highlighting lang, palagay ko naman, kung yun lang ang pagkaiba, siguro hinighlight kung sino may hawak, hinighlight doon ng highlighter. Hindi ibig sabihin peke, kung pareho naman doon. May sinasabi sila na may mga entries doon sa amin na wala rito. Ay, tingnan natin kung ano, magkakaiba ba? Nabago ba itong signature card dahil sa may mga entries? Ano yung mga entries na yun? So, ibig nating mapatunayan ang sinasabi noong testigo na ito'y peke. Dahil hindi naman natin kailangan tanggapin kaagad ang kanilang opinion na ito'y peke. Mm-mm. So, yun po ang aming pakay at yun po ang aming hiningi.
Okay. Now, Senator, what makes a document fraudulent, fake? You know what I mean? Ang legal definition ng fake?
Kung may alteration.
Okay.
Kung mayroong alteration na nagkaiba ngayon ang meaning ng dokumento.
Article 171, 172
Yes. Kung may alteration. By intercalation, ibig sabihin, may isiningit ka.
Okay, something important na siningit,
for example,
additional.
Sa isang dokumento, sinabing, Karen is beautiful. Sisingitan mong Karen is not beautiful. Yung not siningit mo.
Okay.
Yun po ay intercalation, which will result in falsification.
Okay.
So yun ang basically ang rule.
Now, so far, it seems that the Senate is not ruling that this document is falsified. Even if PS Bank has insisted that it's, the lawyer even said it's spurious, altered, fake. The Senate is not buying it.
Until we see the original.
Okay.
So, dahilan sa, yun naman ang, sinasabi nga, the best evidence is the document. Ay, tingnan natin yung original. Kasi sinasabi nila, itong Xerox copy presented, ipeke. O, tingnan natin sa original kung ano ba ang pagkaiba. Ang pagkaiba ba ay substantial? Nagkabago ba ang dokumento? Kung ang sinasabi, sa naririnig ko kahapon, dito sa dokumentong ito, may highlighting sa aming original, wala. Sa akin, hindi yan. Hindi
okay. Now, Senator, isn't it the prosecution's job to reverse PS Bank's testimony and prove, because PS Bank is their witness, to prove that this document is not fake. It's not the Senate's job to do you know what I mean?
Yes.
I want to ask you.
It has gone beyond that. In fact, it was the Senate president himself who said that, well, you, Mr. PS Bank, you have alleged that ito'y peke, and ito'y sinumiti sa amin sa husgado.
And we issued a subpoena.
Kaya sabi ni Ponzi ni Senator Enrile, pinanindigan ko ako ang nag-issue ng subpoena. May karapatan ang aming presiding officer na tingnan kung ano ba talaga itong nangyari dito, at hindi na, wala na pakialam ang depensa o prosecution dito. Dahilan sa nag-issue kami, nag-issue siya ng subpoena on the basis of this.
Now, nakakahiya naman kung nag-issue siya ng subpoena based on a fake document.
Kaya yan, may karapatan ang husgado na tingnan. Kadahilan doon.
Okay. All right. Now, this is on Article 2. Now, tell me, Senator, is this enough, you feel, for Senator judges to already make a determination, because I want to be balanced and fair, or do you still believe that the dollar accounts are important?
Well, I will be going to the merits on that, but I will refrain from that. But just one thing that I point out, Karen, this Annex A of the request for the subpoena, is that being submitted in evidence? What is submitted in evidence are the accounts
here, numbers,
the account numbers and the laman of the accounts.
Okay.
Kaya doon nakita yung isang account na ang ending balance as of December 31, 2010
12.
Ay mahigit sa 12 million.
Yes.
Mayroong isang account na lumagpas ng 8 million.
Yeah. And then there's another one.
And then there's also the two other accounts, yung starting balance nila, kung magkano ang diniposito. At nawala, of course, the deposit disappeared at the year-end. But ang opening balance in two of these accounts sa peso, ay mga 5 million or 2 and 3 million. Uh-oh. 2 million and 3 million. So, yan, ito ulitin ko, itong
Annex A
signature card. Sa pagkaalaala ko, ay hindi sinumite in evidence. Ito'y naging source noong subpoena, itong dahilan dito, source ng subpoena noong mga accounts mismo. Sa katunayan, sinabi ni Garcia na ito mga, hindi ako pwede magtestigo dyan sa mga dollar account. Eh, hindi ka sinabi mo na these are existing. Eh, That's enough. Na these are existing accounts. So, but Karen, I would refrain from answering the question as to whether they still need the dollar account, etc. No, I will not answer that.
But you made a stand during voting that you believed the Senate should not follow the temporary restraining order of the Supreme Court. Why, sir?
We believe that we should not be bound by the Supreme Court.
Because that was a tight vote, 13-10.
13-10, yes.
10 is a lot.
Yes. We believe that the impeachment court is an independent court and cannot be bound by the rulings of the Supreme Court. Ito po ating paliwanag na itong impeachment is part of the check and balance among the three branches.
Yeah.
Kung nag-aabuso po ang isang impeachable officer, walang magawa ang taong bayan. Kung hindi pumunta, kung mayroong betrayal of public trust, mayroong crime committed, wala nang remedyo ang taong bayan, wala nang remedy ang taong bayan kung hindi dumulog sa House of Representatives at humingi na i-impeach ang isang impeachable officer. Kaya ito sa aking paningin at sa mga napag-aralan natin, hindi pwedeng pigilin ng Korte Suprema, dahil kung pipigilin nila, ay di sila na maging impeachment court, hindi na kami. Dahilan sa ito'y binigay sa amin ng saligang batas. Nakalagay sa saligang batas, the Senate shall try and decide. It shall have the sole power to try and decide. Ibig sabihin, wala nang ibang pwedeng makialam. Kaya ganun ang aming position. Ngunit yan, nasa didisidahan. So, tatanggapin ko.
Okay.
Pero ako'y naninindigan na kahit kami natalo sa boto, walang jurisdiction ang Korte Suprema sa amin bilang impeachment court.
Now, but what would be the protection of the respondent in case the impeachment court is abusive, so to speak?
In the same manner, Karen, that when the Supreme Court commits a supreme error, you have no more remedy.
That's true too.
Now, if we commit,
if the Supreme Court makes a final decision that people feel are unfair,
yes,
wala, you respect it.
Yes, o tingnan mo si Bisconde, hindi siya niniwala, but he has to accept the fact that ganun ang decision ng Court Supreme. Hindi ko sinasabing
mali tama o mali. Tama.
Oo. But yun talaga ang sistema natin. Uh-oh. In the same manner, kung magkamali kami sa impeachment court, ang taong bayan ang magsabi, huy, mga gago kayo, kayo, umalis kayo dyan, we will vote you out in the next election. That is the remedy. Hindi yung sasabihin ng Court Supreme, huy, itigil nyo yung inyong impeachment. It cannot be done that way. Otherwise, the Constitution should have lodged in the Supreme Court the power to try and decide impeachment cases.
So clearly you have differing views from Senate President Enrile, but you don't engage in debates.
We debate in caucus.
Okay.
We debate in caucus. We do that in caucus because that is the way of doing. Otherwise, baka hindi na kami mga pagdista kung kami magdidebate araw-araw on those points.
Okay.
In fact, if you recall, one time Senator Enrile issued an opinion on the matter of the admissibility of the evidence, etc. So I just said, you know, I'm standing up in order to register a contrary view, but I don't want to debate.
Yes.
So, because otherwise, if we debate, wala na katapusan.
Now, is it important for you to determine the source of this particular document to make a judgment in the end? Because Senator Jinggoy Estrada says for him, it is important. Yes. He pursued that line of questioning. For you, what does the law say that you believe when it comes to this allegedly leaked document or illegally obtained evidence?
Firstly, itong Annex A, yung signature card, is not part of the evidence.
This is not. This is not. That should be determined.
So, the question is, the accounts which are mentioned here, are they excluded? No. There is no rule of exclusion in the secrecy of banks deposit law, which governs.
Yes.
In other words, it doesn't say that if it is, it comes from this, if it flows, remember, it's not even this one. Huh?
Yeah.
If it flows from an alleged fake document, that you exclude a document which is authentic. Remember, the accounts are not fake. Because
they were acknowledged by the PS Bank president himself.
Five accounts. Dollar accounts. And the peso accounts
were detailed in court.
Presented in detail. Yeah. So these are not fake documents. These are valid documents. So
is the source important?
How
it was obtained?
To me, in this particular case, it is not important.
Okay.
The law does not exclude them. That's my view.
Right? Now, what about 1045? Who is liable? Is it Congressman O'Malley or is it the bank employee?
The bank employee who released it or who leaked it is the one liable because under the law, who is punished? What is punished? It is the willful disclosure by a bank official or employee of bank documents, which would be punishable. That's under the Bank Secrecy Deposit
Act. Now, is the prosecution under the impeachment rules required to admit, declare who their source was? Because journalists would never declare a source.
No.
I'm curious, in an impeachment trial, why go through looking at the CCTV? I mean, the Senate went that hinanap niyo yung small lady, meaning it is important to the Senate.
That's a judgment call. Yeah. Part of, I don't want to comment on that. If O'Malley stands on his record, I don't know what then we do.
Okay.
Stands on what he said. That he got it from a small lady. The small lady is that one in the hospital. She's in the hospital. So. And
that's... Natawa naman ako doon. Okay. Ito, on a light moment, clearly among all the senators, it is only you whom former Justice Secretary and lead defense counsel Serafin Cuevas has the most heated arguments with, okay? The first one when he tried to object.
Well, they have... right now, they filed a petition asking the five of us to be disqualified.
Yes, it was
not only disqualified, Karen. They're saying that because the five are there, stop the trial.
Because yes, this is the supplemental petition.
The supplemental petition.
So, let me say, it is you, Cayetano, Pangilinan, Gingona, and another one.
Sergio Sueña.
Okay, go ahead.
So, firstly, this has absolutely no basis. Because are they saying that we have no capacity to be impartial and look at the evidence? Number two, and even in the strictest judicial process, judges ask questions. And that the answer would favor one party or the other is immaterial. Because ang hinahanap natin dito sa ating pagtatanong ay upang maliwanagan at matingnan kung ano talagang katotohanan. Kaya even under the rules of court and under the decisions of the Supreme Court, hindi po kasalanan na magtanong ang huwes. Hindi po mali na magtanong ang huwes.
Even if hinahanap, it inadvertently helps.
Even if inadvertently helps, that's beside the point. The point is we can ask questions when we want to clarify and seek the truth. Mm-hmm. Dito po, halimbawa, sa kahapon sa nangyari, hinihingi ng husgado yung monthly statement doon sa Bank of PI. Mm-hmm. Ang humingi nito, hindi kami. Mm-mm. Si Serapin Cuevas. Dahil sa record, sabi niya, dalhin mo yung monthly record ng 2005, 2006, 2007, 2008, 2009, 2010. O, siya ko ang humingi.
I heard that. I've been covering. Yeah. So, but didn't he take it back? Didn't he withdraw that when he said Corona had them?
Well, siguro he realized na mali. Pero hindi, parang ano yan, parang toothpaste, hindi mo pwedeng maibalik. Because nag-order na ang husgado to...
Ah, sinabina na kasi.
It's an order in open court.
Yes, it was an order. Yeah.
On open court.
Oh, for her to bring it.
To bring it. Uh-oh. And there was no objection on the part of Cuevas until he probably realized na mali siya. But under the law, the mistakes of counsel is binding on his client.
Yeah, so. And that was not the only time. Actually, when BIR Commissioner Kim Henares took the stand. I'm sorry, I was thinking of the show. Took the stand. It was also the defense counsel during cross-examination who asked Kim Henares about the salen.
That's correct. There. Then, when he asked Kim Henares about the salen, which, by the way, the prosecution did not ask for,
yes,
gave an opportunity to Kim Henares
to compare.
So, you know.
And she was unstoppable, frankly. I mean, Kim Henares just went on and on on her calculations.
The first rule on cross-examination is do not cross-examine a very bright witness.
Is that right?
Yes.
Don't cross-examine or leave the bright witness alone.
No, especially that she was just testifying on the basis of the records with her.
An income tax return.
Anong gagawin mo dyan?
Okay. Now, before we take a quick break, very quickly, because there are so many questions coming in from Twitter and Facebook for you. Paano ba talaga magsulat ng salin? Kasi ngayon, ang buong Pilipinas, kung may isang naturo dito, uy, dapat seryosohin yung salin na yan. I mean, congressmen and senators are criticized. They don't even fill it up properly. Well, all right, how do you really do it? Three columns when you value the salin. This was written to us by a BIR, retired BIR official, certified public accountant lawyer. She said, cost, fair market value, assessed value.
That's correct. Okay. Under the salin, ganun, tatlong column. Kaya yung tama yung sinasabi niya. First, the assessed value, which is what the local government uses for purposes of the real property tax.
Yeah, so let's put it to me, not Corona.
Okay.
I buy a house.
You buy a house.
Yes.
First, what is the assessed value of the house?
It's found
in the records of the city hall.
Okay, so let's say sabi nila 50 million.
Okay, 50 million, all right. Now, what is the fair market value?
Let's say I bought it for 56.
56 million. That the fair market value is what the seller is willing to sell and the buyer is willing to buy.
Okay.
That is the fair market value under the law and under this paper of the...
So in the sal, and where should I put that?
In the column says fair market value.
Okay.
Yung third column is acquisition cost.
How much I bought it.
How much you bought it.
Okay.
So it's not difficult to understand.
Now, In Chief Justice Corona's sal-end, the acquisition cost was empty. I'm correct, no? I
mean, that's correct, yeah. Yes.
Because we're going on memory, we don't see it in the studio.
Yes.
So it's empty. The acquisition cost is empty.
Blank. Yes.
The fair market value of the Bellagio apartment, this struck me because they said he bought it for 14 million, but the fair market value that was written was 6 million.
That's correct, Karen. That's okay. Correct.
Yeah,
that's
so my memory is good.
That's correct. Yeah, there is a difference there. And I'm sure that in his defense, he will try to explain
why.
But they're just talking about facts.
Facts.
There is a difference in in what appears to be the fair market value and the price that appears to have been the purchase price between Mega World and Chief Justice Corona. He'll try to explain.
He will try, of course. All right, we'll take a quick break. When we return, my gosh, so many questions for our guest. Get ready. Senator Judge Franklin Drilon will answer questions from you, our viewers. Tweet your questions right now. You know what? I think I've already had 300 tweets come in for you.
As long as you spell my name correctly, that's fine.
Okay, all right. Hot Copy, we'll be right back.